see vastly improved grade recovery curves with the Mach compared to the base case, with the Mach providing both higher grade and recovery. This is attributable to the improved flotation of better liberated, higher grade fines with the Mach reactor. This is useful in both roughing and cleaning circuits. I say it quite casually, but it's actually quite a phenomenal achievement. For UG2 PGM ore, we have also seen a definite trend with reduced chrome recovery with the Mach when compared to the base case. It is hypothesized that this may be due to the removal of talc rims on the chromatite particles or due to froth layer modification leading to reduced entrainment. Studies are ongoing to deepen our understanding of the various mechanisms that could be at play. How would we install a Mach then on an existing float plant? Well, what we at Goldor view as essential is a multi-pass system on a conditioning tank ahead of the flotation bank, supported by recirculation directly on flotation cells to maintain the pick or bubble effect down the float bank. There are existing clients that have installed the Mach also for external aeration on flotation columns to good effect. Hence, the Mach may be relatively easily retrofitted into existing plants. This is an AutoCAD depiction of the gold ore version of high intensity flotation with Mach reactors recirculating directly on a flotation cell. This application was commissioned about 18 months ago and is delivering exceptional results. So now let's move on to the application of the Mach in the gold industry. You would have noticed from the earlier slides that I put up that the mere 2% improvement in gold recovery can have remarkable impact on incremental revenue and incremental profit. And this is largely attributable to the gold price, which is the best that it has been for years now, and with analysts predicting that it will go even higher in future. So this is the ideal time to be looking at ways to improve recoveries. The Mach finds popular application in the pre-oxidation and boosted leach applications on gold plants. So why do we need pre-oxidation? Well, the presence of sulfides in ore bodies presents a challenge in that the cyanidation process actually it tends to leach out ferrous and sulfide iron, which consume cyanide to form ferrocyanide complexes and ferrocyanate. As you can see from the chemical reaction, ferrocyanide is a huge consumer of cyanide. Ferrocyanate also consumes cyanide, but can also cause other issues as it can also complex with gold. The issue that arises is that the gold ferrocyanate complex does not easily absorb onto activated carbon, and this can drive up soluble losses. Additionally, the ferrocyanate complex is not destroyed by the widely used SMBS air cyanide destruction process, and the buildup of ferrocyanate in tailings dam return water can pose both environmental and process problems if the situation is not adequately addressed. Pre-oxidation oxidizes ferrous to ferric and precipitates ferric hydroxide and even more stable ferric oxyhydroxides. Sulfide is oxidized to sulfate in an exothermic reaction that produces sulfuric acid. Pre-oxidation also forms a surface film of ferric hydroxide on the surface of the reactive mineral, preventing it from leaching out when cyanide is added for the gold leach. Where there is very reactive pyrrhotite present, additional lime may have to be added to maintain desirable leach pH. The cyanide savings usually far outweigh the cost of lime. A 25 to 30% reduction in cyanide consumption can be achieved by using the Mach reactor for pre-oxidation. Laboratory test work, which can be done at MinTech in South Africa and ALS in Perth, may be used to gauge any potential cyanide savings, and on-site plant trials with full-scale reactors may also be done with limited risk to assess the suitability of the Mach for your operation. You may email me at adrian@goldor.org if you are interested. I'm sure that we're all aware of Elsner's equation, which shows that you need both cyanide and oxygen to leach gold. Just how much oxygen is required is a subject of much debate, with different researchers proposing different ratios. Generally, my experience has been that as long as the dissolved oxygen levels are below 15 ppm, you should be fine. Above 15 ppm, I should say. Nevertheless, from a chemistry point of view, and owing to the fact that cyanide is added in excess, oxygen is usually the rate limiting reagent on most gold plants.